is into the Montreal zone. Brad Boyes to Molson. He hit the post. Molson let go a rocket and shot it off the far post. Hickey missed it. Michael Ryder, number 73, chases it down. Basically throws Martinik down. It comes in front. Plekanec scores. Thomas Plekanec has given the Canadiens a 1-0 lead.
Well, the Islanders were lazy in getting back into their defensive zone. The Canadiens using that speed, particularly Ryder. Ryder, watch the speed with Ryder goes in, fighting with Radek Martinik. The puck just stays there and slides over. No one's got the front of the net again.
Ryder back to work, dropping it off towards Galchenyuk. That puck just stayed in, even though Galchenyuk did not. He wound up in the Islander bench.
Good check by Casey Cizikas as he's able to with a pretty solid hit on Galchenyuk, staring at the referee.
You didn't see him slam that gate to the bench. You could hear it. Molson shoots. He scores! Matt Molson with a power play goal, and the Islanders tie it 1-1. Reasoner across. First for Grabner. He gets it back. He shoots. High stick by Ahlstrom to knock it down, but a Canadian Coverley plays it next. So play continues. Grabner fires and a kick save made by Price. Islanders getting great pressure now.
Mullen was the guy that came in and got him.
That puck came up and stunned Gallagher. Tavares brings it in, takes it wide, shoots, save, juggled by Price. And then it looked like Bouillon might have been holding Boyes in pursuit. Minute 14 remaining to what is now a 5-on-4 Islander power play. Boyes carries in, checked at the line, recovered by Tavares. Now to Boyes, in front, score, Martin! Matt Martin with a power play goal!
I'm saying, you know, he kills penalties also. Now he's showing that he can be productive, at least on that shift, on the power play, so.
Well, he has a good shot, he has good hockey sense, and he certainly won the battle.
And Grabner makes it 3-1. The Islanders' first even strength goal of the game.
Well, we've seen all the bad bounces over the last 10 games for the Islanders. Now we're starting to see some good bounces as the puck is shot. Watch it ricochet right to Michael Grabner. Casey Cizikas is in front providing the screen, but that's a fortuitous bounce for Michael Grabner.
Andrew McDonald for holding at 14:47. So they set up the man advantage. Markov and Subban on the points. This is Pacioretty with Gallagher and Desharnais. He deflected that puck into Nabokov. It's pounded in well after the whistle. Desharnais feeds Pacioretty. Subban lines up a shot. That's blocked by Grabner. Subban again. He hit the post. Subban let go a laser that Pacioretty just does manage to keep in. Lekanec, Markov, Subban a drive, kicked out by Nabokov. 4 seconds to the 5-on-3. Subban drives one. He scores. And I believe it was after Chyliposo on the right wing to Nielsen with Bailey open. Nielsen shoots. He hit the post. It's a couple here in the second period. That one tipped by Bailey and stopped by Price. Subban for Galchenyuk. He throws it deep. Nabokov out to stop it. Only got it as far as the corner. Ryder back to Subban. That drive stopped by Nabokov as Hamonic knocks Galchenyuk down after the whistle.
Goaltender and no rebound play.
Here's Markov, 14 to the period. Subban fires, save, rebound, loose, the whistle. As a scrum just in front of Nabokov, had that puck loose for a moment. Donald and Hamonic for the Islanders. A steal by Grabner, a backhander, as stopped by Price. And the Islanders with an instant shorthanded opportunity. Stealing away from Martin, setting up Subban. That drive was tipped by Markov and stopped by Nabokov. Now Subban again. Let's go. It drives. Stick save. Rebound. Score. Ryan Giotto with a power play goal has tied at 3-3. Bailey to Hickey. Martinik shot tip. And that forced Price to scramble over. Now Martinik again. Let's go. It drives. Score.
I believe that goes off of Franz Nielsen, Howie.
Oh, the Tavares line on. Boyes couldn't get a shot off. It's loose. Tavares scores. John Tavares with a minute and 7 to go has given the Islanders a 5-3 lead. Cizikas for Martin. He's got the empty net with Colin McDonald. It's McDonald who finishes.
Talk about an unselfish play. Matt Martin could have easily chipped that.